thank you so much for coming this evening. Really thrilled with the turnout. Welcome to the world premiere of a new adaptation called Shakespeare's Women, focusing around the arcs of six different famous Shakespeare heroines and the journey that they take. Just some housekeeping stuff. Emergency exits right there and there. Please, please, please refrain from taking pictures of the show, videoing the show. We have someone recording the show. We have some great pictures. As you see, we're going to keep the lights just like this, so you guys tonight are very much a part of the show, right? There are seven young actresses working extremely hard, doing some fantastic work. There's an eighth actor this evening, and that is you guys. In Shakespeare's time, we perform in two different theaters, the Globe Theater outdoors, in the daylight, and then later on in his career, he would come indoor at the Blackfriars, and that's what we've tried to recreate here on the Trinity stage. He performs plays beneath the umbered candlelight, and that's what's going on here today. So thank you so much for coming. I know you're very tired of hearing me talk and use words like umbered. But thank you so much for coming, and please enjoy Shakespeare's Women.
Sing or Express yourself in a more comfortable sort. If my son were my husband, I should rejoice in that absence wherein he won honor. When yet he was but tender-bodied, and the only son of my womb, I was pleased to let him see danger where he was like to find fame. To a cruel war I sent him, and whence he returned, his brows bound with oak. I tell thee, daughter, I sprang not more in joy at first hearing he was a man-child than now at first seeing he had proved himself a man.
And had he died in the business, madam, how then?
Then his good report should have been my son. I therein would have found issue. Hear me profess sincerely, had I a dozen sons, I had rather 11 die nobly for their country than one voluptuously surfeit out of action.
Beseech you, give me leave to retire myself.
Indeed you shall not. Methinks I hear him your husband strong. See him pluck up, but he's down by the hair. See him stamp thus, and call thus, come on, you cowards! You were got in fear, though you were born in Rome! His bloody brow, with his mailed hand, then wiping, forth he goes.
His bloody brow, O Jupiter, no blood!
Away, you fool! And more he becomes a man.
Heavens bless my lord!
He'll beat off Phineas' head below his knee, and tread upon his neck!
Ophelia is adored by the Prince of Denmark, Hamlet. While away at college, he writes beautiful love letters to her.
To the celestial and my soul's idol, most beautiful Ophelia. Doubt that the stars are fire. Doubt that the sun don't move. Doubt should to be higher. But never doubt I want. Oh, dear Ophelia! I'm ill at these numbers. I have not art to beckon my girls, but that I love the best, almost best. Believe it, do, Hamlet.
Desdemona. Desdemona has secretly married the love of her life, Othello. Another of her suitors tells her father, and he asks her who she owes allegiance.
My noble father, do you perceive here a divided duty? To you I am bound for life and education. Life and education both do learn me how to respect you. I am your daughter, but here is my husband. And so much duty as my mother showed to you, preferring you before her father, so much I may profess to Othello. I love Othello and shall live with him. If not, my downright violence and storm of fortunes may trumpet to the world. I saw Othello's visage in my mind, to his honor and his valiant parts, did I my soul and fortunes consecrate. So that, dear lords, if I be left behind but a moth of peace and he go to war, the rights from which I love him are bereft me. And I, as a heavy interim, shall support him by his dear absence. Let me go with him.
Queen Margaret, Henry VI frets over the growing unrest in the kingdom and wonders if his confidant Gloucester is loyal. The Earl of Suffolk and Queen Margaret try to convince him that Gloucester has betrayed them. TJ, can you play King Henry?
I guess.
And Chris, will you play Suffolk?
As long as I have to play piano.
Gloucester is a man full of deep deceit.
The Duke is
presumptuous smile and too well given to dream evil or work my devil.
Seems he a dove? His feathers are but borrowed, for he is disposed as the hateful raven. Is he a lamb? His skin is surely lent him, for he is inclined as a ravenous wolf. Take heed, my lord. The welfare of us all hangs on the cutting short that frauds on man.
Juliet. Romeo and Juliet fall further in love, and Romeo swears that he will marry her. The next day, Juliet sends her best friend and nurse, that's me, to meet Romeo and find out if his intention to marry her was sincere, and if he was able to convince the friar to perform the marriage rite. Juliet is impatiently awaiting my return.
The clock struck 9 when I did send the nurse. In half an hour, she promised to return. Perchance she could not meet him. That's not so. She is lame. Love's herald should be thoughts which glide 10 times faster than the sun's beams. Now is the sun upon the highmost hill of this day's journey, and from 9 to 12 is 3 long hours. Yet she has not come. Had she affections and warm youthful blood, she would be in swift emotion as a ball. My words would bandy her to my sweet love, and his to me. But old folks, many would feign as if they were dead, unwieldy, slow, heavy, and pale as lead.
Oh God, here comes my nurse, and she brings news.
Okay.
Now, nurse, what news? Hast thou met with him?
Oh, I am aweary. Give me leave a while. Fie, how my bones ache. What a jaunt have I had.
I would thou had my bones and I thy news. Nay, come, I pray thee speak. Good nurse, speak.
Hesu, what haste? Can you not stay a while? Do you not see I am out of breath?
How art thou out of breath when thou hast breath to say to me that thou art out of breath? Is thy news good or bad? Answer to that.
Well, you have made a simple choice. You know not how to choose a man. Romeo.
What says he of our marriage? What of that?
Oh, how my head aches! What a head have I! It beats as it would fall in 20 pieces! And oh, my back!
Oh,
okay. The other side?
In faith, I am sorry that thou art not well. Sweet, sweet, sweet nurse, tell me, what says my love?
Well, your love says, like an honest gentleman, and a courteous,
yeah,
and a kind,
okay,
and a handsome.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm more virtuous. Where's your mother?
Well, where is thy mother? Why, she is within. Your love said, like an honest gentleman. Where is thy mother?
Oh, gods, lady dear, are you so hot? Henceforward, your messages yourself.
Here's such a coil. Come, what says Romeo?
Have you got leave to go to shrift tomorrow?
I have.
Then hie you hence to Friar Lawrence's cell. There stays a husband to make you a wife. Oh, here comes the wanton blood up in your cheeks. Hie to church, hie to high fortune.
Honest nurse, farewell.
Volumna. Coriolanus returns to Rome triumphant. However, he offends the people with his brash personality. Ever the politician, his mother begs him to return to the people and ask for their pardon. Graham, will you play Coriolanus?
Just give me a second. Oh my God. This is happening. What should I do?
Return to the tribunes.
Well, what then? What then?
Repent when you have spoke.
For them, I cannot do to the gods, but I then do it to them.
You are too absolute.
Why force you this?
Because now it lies on you to speak to the people. Not by your own instruction, but with such words that have no allowance to your bosom's truth. Now this no more dishonors you at all than to take in a town with gentle words. I prithee now, my son, go to them. With thy heart in thy hand, thy knee kissing the stone, say to the people, thou art their soldier, and being bred in broils has not the soft way which were fit for asking their good loves. But thou wilt frame thyself hereafter theirs, so long as thou hast power in person. When this is done, their hearts are yours. Prithee now go and be ruled.
Must I go show them my unbarred sconce? Must I, with base tongue, give my heart a lie that it must bear?
For thee now, sweet son.
My throne of war be turned into a pipe small to babies. I will not do it.
At thy choice, then, to beg thee is my more dishonor. Come all to ruin, let thy mother rather feel thy pride than fear thy dangerous stoutness. Do as thou list. Thy valiantness was mine. Thou sucks it from me, but owe thy pride thyself.
Pray be content. Mother, I am going to the marketplace. Chide me no more.
Do your will.
Desdemona. Michael Cassio has dishonored himself in a drunken brawl, and asked Desdemona to talk to Othello on his behalf. Iago has begun to poison Othello's mind with jealousy, and he believes that Desdemona is going to betray him with Cassio. Maurice, will you play Othello?
Of course! That's my dream role!
How now, my lord? I have been talking with a man that languishes in your displeasure.
Who is do you mean?
Why, Lieutenant Cassio. Good, my lord, if I have any power or grace to move you, his present reconciliation with me.
Whence he has now?
I sue, so humbled that he hath left part of his grief with me to suffer with him. Good love, call me back.
Not now, sweet Desdemona. Some other time.
Shall be tonight at dinner?
No, not tonight.
Tomorrow, supper then.
I shall not dine at home. I mean the captain's at the Citadel.
Why then, tomorrow night? Tuesday morn? Tuesday noon or night? On Wednesday morn, I prithee name the time, but let it not exceed 3 days. In faith, he's penitent. When shall he come? Tell me, Othello, I wonder in my soul what you would ask me that I should deny, or stand so mammering on. What? Michael Cassio, that came a wooing with you so many a time when I had spoken Eunice brazenly, hath ta'en your part to have so much to do to bring him in. Trust me, I can do much.
Pray thee no more. Let him come when he will. I can do nothing.
Why, this is not a boon. 'Tis as I should entreat you to wear your gloves, or feed on nourishing dishes, or keep you warm, or sue you to a particular profit to your own person. Nay, when I have a suit wherein I mean to touch your love indeed, it shall be filled with weight, poise, and fearful to be granted.
I will deny you nothing. Leave me but a little to myself.
Farewell, my lord.
Farewell, my Desdemona. I'll come to thee straight.
Whatever you be, I am obedient.
Queen Margaret. Margaret and Suffolk have gone behind the king's back and murdered Gloucester. They tried to deceive King Henry into thinking it was someone else.
How now? Why lookest thou pale? What's the matter, Suffolk?
Dead in his bed, my lord. Gloucester is dead!
Harry, help defend!
Heavenly God!
How fares my gracious lord?
Comfort, my sovereign. Gracious Henry, comfort!
Does my lord of Suffolk comfort me? Lay not thy poisoned and sugared words. Take your hands off.
Why do you rate my lord Suffolk thus? Although the Duke was enemy to him, yet he most Christian-like laments his death. And as for myself, foe as he was to me, I would be blind with weeping, sick with groans, and all to have the noble Duke alive. Ah, oh, me to be a queen and crowned with infamy.
Woe is me for Gloucester, wretched man.
Be woe for me, more wretched than he is. What, dost thou turn away and hide thy face? I'm no lonesome lover. Look on me! What, art thou like the adder wax in death? Be poisonous too, and kill thy forlorn queen. Was all thy comfort shut in Gloucester's tomb? Why then, Dame Margaret was ne'er thy joy. Erect his statue and worship it, and make my image but an alehouse sign. Ay me, I can no more. Die, Margaret, for any dost weep that thou livest so long.
Suffolk, I swear, thou shalt not breathe infection in this air but 3 days longer on the pain of death.
Oh, Henry, let me plead for gentle Suffolk.
Ungentle queens call him gentle Suffolk. No more, I say. If thou beest here in 3 days, thou shalt die.
Miscant and sorrow go along with you.
Now get thee hence. The king shall return, and if thou be found by me, thou art but dead.
If I flee from thee, I cannot live. Well, let me stay, but follow me befall.
Juliet waits for her new husband. Unbeknownst to her, a massive fight between the two families occurs in the streets of Verona. Juliet's cousin Tybalt murders Romeo's best friend Mercutio. Enraged, Romeo kills Tybalt. All the while, Juliet waits for her love.
Gallop apace, you fiery-footed steeds, towards Phoebus' lodging. Come, knight, come. Oh, Romeo, come. Gentle knight, come. Give me my Romeo, and when he shall die, take him and cut him out into little stars, and he will make the face of heaven so fine that all the world will be in love with the knight and pay no worship to the garish sun. Oh, here comes my nurse, and she brings news. Now, nurse, what news? Oh, what a day. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. We are undone, lady, we are undone. Oh, alack the day, he's gone. He's killed, he's dead.
Can heaven be so envious?
Romeo can, though heaven cannot. Romeo, Romeo, whoever would have thought it, Romeo.
Is Romeo slaughtered, and is Tybalt dead?
Oh, I saw the wound, I saw it with mine eyes.
Desdemona tries to seek the cause draws with her best friend Amelia, who I'll be playing. Is not this man jealous?
I ne'er saw this before.
'Tis only a year or two shows us a man. They all but stomachs, and we all but food, to eat us hungrily, and when they are full, they belch us.
My lord is not my lord, nor should I know him.
My lord is angry.
Something, sure, of state hath puddled his clear spirit. And in such cases, men's natures wrangle with inferior things, though great ones be their objects. We must think men are not gods.
Pray heaven it be state matters as you think, and no jealousy concerning you.
Alas, the day! I never gave him cause.
Jealous souls will not be answered so. They are never jealous for the cause. Jealous, for they are jealous. It is a monster begot upon itself, born on itself.
Heaven keep that monster from Othello's mind.
Lady, amen.
I will go seek him.
Ophelia, Hamlet's father has been murdered, and he returns to Denmark. His father's ghost begins to haunt him, and he starts to lose his mind. The relationship between him and Ophelia begins to I'll be playing Queen Gertrude, Hamlet's mother.
My lord, as I was sewing in my closet, Lord Hamlet, with his doublet all embraced, his stocking spout, and guarded pale as his shirt, his knees knocking each other as if he had been loosened out of hell that came before me.
Mad for thy love?
My lord, I do not know, but truly I do.
What said
he? He grabbed me by my wrist and he held me hard, long save so. At last, a little shaking of my arm, he let out a sigh so piteous and profound, it did seem to shatter all his bulk and end his being. That done, he let me go and found his way out of doors.
This is the very ecstasy of love. I am sorry. Have you given him any harsh words of late?
No, my good lord. But as you did command, I did repel his letters and denied his access to me.
This hath made him mad. Come, go we to the king. This must be known. Cleopatra. Cleopatra discovers that while Anthony is away, he has taken a wife. She is enraged and sends a messenger to find out all about his new love. The messenger has returned, and Cleopatra questions her.
Where is the fellow?
Have fear to come.
Go to, come thou hither, sir.
Good majesty, Herod himself dare not look upon thee, but when you are well pleased.
Come thou near.
Most gracious majesty.
Did thou behold Octavia?
I did, madam.
She as tall as me?
She is not, madam.
Did thou hear her speak? Is she shrill of tongue or low?
Madam, she is old.
Oh, that is not so good. She cannot like her long.
Like her? Oh, rot, 'tis impossible.
I think so, charming. Dull of tongue and dwarfish? What majesty is in her gait?
She breathes.
Is this certain?
Or I have no observance.
Guess that her ears are pretty.
Madam, she's a widow.
Oh, widow, charming. Oh, my.
She's 30.
She's 30. Oh, I do, baby. Why, go make me ready for more employment. Why, methinks this creature knows such thing.
Nothing, madam.
The man hath seen some majesty and should know. I will lead my armies together, Anthony, and I will defeat Caesar.
This course is one fraught with peril.
My mind is settled. I will to war protect my Egypt and win back my Rome.
But why? Why? Why?
Thou hast forespoke me being in these wars and say it is not fit.
Well, is it? Is it?
What? And now be there in person. What is it you say?
Your presence needs must puzzle Anthony. Take from his heart, take from his brain, for times that should not be spared. To set in Rome that you and your maids manage this war.
Sink Rome! And rot the tongues that speak against it. A charge we bear in the war as president of my kingdom. I will not stay behind. Do not speak against it.
Desdemona. Othello grows increasingly jealous, and he begins to take his
not the words.
Why? What art thou?
Your wife, your true and loyal wife.
Come swear it, damn thyself.
Heaven doth truly know it.
Heaven truly knows your false as hell.
To whom, my lord? With whom? How am I false?
Desdemona, away, away!
Alas, the heavy day! Why do you weep? Am I the motive of these tears, my lord? Oh, my noble lord esteems me honest. Alas, what ignorant sin have I committed?
Committed? Committed? Committed? Committed! Oh, thou public commoner, impotent strumpet!
By heaven, you do me wrong.
Are you not a strumpet?
No, as I am a Christian.
What, not a strumpet?
No, as I shall be saved.
It's possible!
How do you, good madam? How do you, sweet lady?
Faith, half asleep.
What is the matter with my lord?
Who is thy lord?
He that is yours, sweet lady.
I have none. Do not talk to me, Amelia. I cannot weep, nor answer have I none. Prithee, tonight, lay on my bed my wedding sheets. Remember! Call my husband.
Queen Margaret, on the king's order, Suffolk has been beheaded. Queen Margaret mourns the loss, and is so affected by it that she carries Suffolk's severed head with her wherever she goes. Meanwhile, the rebels gain strength.
Oft have I heard that grief softens the mind and makes it fearful and degenerate. Think therefore in revenge and cease to weep. Who can cease to weep and look on this? Here may his head lie on my throbbing breast. But where's the body that I should embrace?
Still lamenting and mourning over Suffolk's death? I fear, my love, that thou, if I had been dead, thou wouldst not have mourned so for me.
No, my love. Should not mourn, but die for thee.
What news? Why comes down such peace?
The rebels are in Southwark. Fly, my lord.
Oh, were the Duke of Suffolk now alive, these Kentish rebels would soon be appeased.
Jack Hay hath taken London Bridge. The citizens fly and forsake their houses.
Margaret, only hope and God can save us now.
My hope is gone, now Suffolk is seized. Come on, my lord, for shame, away!
Can we outrun the heavens?
What are you made of? You'll nor fight nor fly. Now is manhood, wisdom, and defense to give way to the enemy to secure us. If you be tame, we shall see the bottom of all our fortunes. But if we happily escape, as well we may, if not for your neglect, we shall to London get, where you are loved, and where this breach in our fortunes made may readily be stopped.
Juliet, after saying their tender goodbyes, Romeo flees Verona, leaving Juliet. Her parents decide that she will marry the rich cousin of the Prince of Paris. Since Juliet is already married to Romeo, this would be a mortal sin, and she refuses. Her father threatens to throw her out of the house, to die in the streets, so she pretends to acquiesce. On advice of the friar, she plans to take a poison on the night before the wedding that will make her appear dead.
Farewell. God knows when we shall meet again. Old fear thrills through my veins and almost oozes up the heat of life. I'll call them back again to comfort me.
Nurse!
What should she do here? My dismal scene I needs must act alone.
reported plague of the gods upon you. I'll tell thee what. I would my son here and thy tribe before him, his good sword in his hand. He'd make an end to thy posterity. Bastards and all! Ere I go, hear this. As far as doth the capital exceed the meanest house in Rome, my son, whom you have banished, does exceed you all. I would the gods have nothing else to do but to confirm my curses!
Cleopatra, the war has gone very badly, and Anthony has lost. They bring him dying back to Cleopatra, and she mourns over his body.
Does the meanest chores. It were for me, I'd throw my scepter to injurious gods and tell them that our world did equal theirs, though they had stolen our jewel.
Also not. Then is it sin to rush to the secret house of death, ere death dare take us? How do you, women? What good cheer?
Ophelia confronts Hamlet and distances herself from the ever-maddening prince.
Good, my lord. How does Hamlet do for this many a day? I have remembrances of yours that I have longed to redeliver. Could you not receive them?
No, not I. I never gave you aught. No! You should not have believed me! I loved you not!
I was the more deceived.
Get thee to a nunnery!
Oh, help him, you sweet heavens!
To a nunnery! Go! Farewell! And quickly, too! To a nunnery! Go! Farewell!
To hell and die, restore him!
To a nunnery! Go!
Oh, woe is me. To have seen what I've seen. mother, a maid called Barbara. She was in love, and he she loved proved mad and did forsake her. She had a song of willow, an old thing t'was, but it expressed her fortunes. She died singing it. That song tonight will not go from my mind. Poor soul sad, sighed by so much room. Sing the fall free below.
With more men. Sing, Willow, Willow, Willow.
My eyes, they do itch. To that bone weeping. Good night. Good night. Me such uses said, not to pick bad from bad, but by bad, bad men.
Queen Margaret, the rebels are gaining power, and Margaret is losing her grip on Henry. She makes one last plea for him to fight.
Nay, go not from me.
Patience, dear Margaret, I will say.
Who can be patient in such extremes? Oh, wretched man! Would I had died a maid, never seen thee, never borne thee a son, seeing thou so, prove so unnatural a father! Hath he deserved to lose his birthright thus? Hadst thou loved him half so well as I, thou never would have had that savage duke thine heir and disinherited thy only son.
Pardon me, Margaret, pardon me. The Earl of Warwick and the Duke have enforced thee.
Enforced thee? Art thou king and wilt be forced? I shame to hear thee speak. Thou hast undone thyself, thy son, and me. Had I been here, a silly woman, the soldiers should have thrown me on their pikes before I would have granted to such an act. But thou preferest thy life before thy honor. And seeing thou dost, I here divorce myself, Henry, both from thy table and thy bed, until that act of parliament be repealed whereby my son is disinherited. The northern lords that have sworn thy colors yet will follow mine. Utter ruin to the house of York. And thus I leave thee. My army is ready.
Stay, good Margaret, and hear me speak.
Thou hast spoke too much already. Get thee gone.
Volumna, Coriolanus is banished and vows revenge upon Rome. He joins with Rome's enemy and leads a vast army to the gates of Rome. He's about to destroy the city when his mother confronts him and begs him to change his mind.
Should we be silent and not speak? Think with thyself how more unfortunate than all living women are we come hither. Since that thy sight, which should make our eyes flow with joy, hearts dance with comforts, constrains them weep and shake with fear and sorrow, making the mother, wife, and child see the son, the husband, and the father tearing his country's bowels out. Thou barst us our prayers to the God, which is a comfort that all shed thy wife and children's blood. For myself, son, I purpose not to wait on fortune till these wars determine. If I cannot persuade thee, thou shalt no sooner march to assault thy country than tread on thy mother's womb that brought thee to this world. Thou knowest, great son, the end of war is uncertain, but this certain, that if thou conquer Rome, the benefit which thou shalt reap is such a name, whose repetition will be daubed with curses, whose chronicle thus writ, the man was noble, but in his last attempt, he wiped it out, destroyed his country, and his name remains to the ensuing age abhorred. Speak to me, son. Why dost not speak? There is no man in the world more bound to his mother, yet here he lets me prate like one of the stocks. Down, ladies, let us shame him with our knees. Down, and end. This is the last, so we will home to Rome and die amongst our neighbors. Come, let us go. I am hushed till our city be afire.
Oh, mother, what have you done? The heavens do hope, the gods look down, and on this unnatural scene they laugh at. Oh, mother, you have won a happy victory to Rome.
Believe it, though I cannot make true wars, I'll frame a convenient peace. Mother, you deserve to have a temple built to you. All the swords in Italy and her confederate arms could not have made such a peace.
Cleopatra. The Greek queen has lost everything, and there is only one action left for her to take.
Give me my robe. Put on my crown. I have more longings in me now. No more the juice of Egypt's grape shall moist this lip. Methinks I hear Anthony call. I see him rouse himself to praise my noble act. I hear him mock the luck of Caesar, which the gods give to men to excuse their after wrath. Husband, I come to that name. My courage proved my title. I am fire, and I am air. Into my other elements, I give to baser life. Farewell.
Say the gods themselves do weep. Oh, break! Oh, break!
Thank you.
for shame. Young men will do if they come to. By God, they are to blame. Woe he, before you tumbled me, you promised me to wed, and so what I have done by yonder son, thou hast not come to my God.
How long has she been thus?
I hope all will be well. We must be patient. But I cannot choose to weep, to think.
Shall know it!
And so I thank you for your good counsel. Good night, ladies. Good night, sweet ladies. Good night. Good night. Here's rosemary for you. That's remembrance. Pray, love, remember. And here's pansies. That's for thoughts.
Document madness. Thoughts and remembrance fitted.
Queen Margaret, her husband has been killed, her son murdered. She is no longer queen, but a prisoner of the new regime. She addresses the new court and king.
What, were you snarling all before I came? Ready to catch each other by the throats? And turn you all your hatred now on me? Can curses pierce the clouds and enter heaven? Why then give way, dull clouds, to my quick curses? By war die your king. Edward, thy son, die in his youth. Long mayst thou live to wail thy children's loss. You were standers by, and so was thou, when my son was stabbed with bloody daggers. I pray that none of you may live your natural age, but by some unlooked accident cut off. And leave out thee? Stay, dog, for thou shalt hear me. Oh, if heaven have any grievous plague in store, let them hail down their indignation on thee. The worm of conscience will gnaw thy soul. No sleep close up that eye of thine unless it be whilst a tormenting dream affrights thee with the hell of ugly devils. Thou slave of nature and thy son of hell, thy slander of thy mother's heavy womb, thy loathed issue of thy father's loins, thy rag of honor!
Juliet, chaos, confusion, plague. Romeo does not receive the message containing Juliet's intentions. He visits her tomb and mourns over her body. He is rash and impetuous and takes his own life with a fatal drug. She awakens the moment he takes his last breath, and he dies in her arms.
What's this? A cup closed in my true love's hands? Poison I see hath been his timeless end. Oh, churl, drunk all of them, no friendly drunk down!
Desdemona. Despite her best efforts, Desdemona cannot convince Othello that she is innocent of any wrongdoing. She awaits her love with a heavy heart.
Tonight, Desdemona? If you bethink yourself of any crime, unreconciled as yet to heaven and grace, solicit for it straight.
Yes, my lord, what do you mean by that?
I would not kill thy soul.
Talk you of killing?
Aye, I do.
Then heaven have mercy on me.
Amen, with all my heart.
If you say so, I hope you will not kill me. Yet, I fear you.
Think on thy sins.
They are loves I bear to you.
Aye, and thou art diest.
Death's unnatural that kills for loving.
Peace and be still.
I will so. What's the matter?
Thou art on thy deathbed.
Aye, but not yet to die.
Yes, presently. Confess thee freely of thy sin, thou art to die.
Then, Lord, have mercy on me.
I say amen.
And have you mercy too. I never did offend you in my life.
Oh, perjured woman, thou dost stone my heart and makest me call what I intend to do a murder, which I thought a sacrifice.
Banish me, my lord, but kill me not.
Thou trumpet!
Kill me tomorrow, let me live tonight.
Nay, if you strive.
But half an hour!
Being late, there is no pause.
Well, I say, my Lord, prayer.
It is too late.
What? What? I can't stand my death!
Rose. Of angel hair.
My dismal scene, I needs must act.
And ice cream castles in the air.
Lord, we know we are, but now
and
we may be.
Everywhere.
I am fire, I am air.
Look to clouds that way.
Oft have I heard that grief softens the mind.
But now they only walk the sun.
The hoarded plague of the gods upon you.
They rain and they snow on everyone.
That death's unnatural that kills for loving.
So many things I would have done. But clouds guard in my way.
I am a woman. When I think I must speak.